You always wanted to know how to carry games with Graves? I'm gonna show you in my gameplay commentary. See you in game. Hey guys, so here we go. This is my second Graves gameplay. The other one was kind of muted. I forgot to unmute my mic. So I hope you can learn a lot from this one. I'm gonna start machete and refillable, and I will start at the red buff. Pretty standard stuff over here. I hope Fiora will give me a good leash so I can go to the golems, and then we will see how the game goes. The jungle, you always have to adapt your playstyle. So I guess it's the hardest lane, or the hardest role to learn when you begin with. But once you figure it out how to play jungle, it's not that hard, you know? Always depends on the elo you're on, or in. Gonna do this stuff over here. Always keep petting the camps so you don't get any damage. Always save your refillable potion you can for trades with the enemy jungler. I'll try to Okay, easy first blood. Gonna help him push a bit. Do a bit of damage. Don't want to steal a lot of XP. The Rengar is at my blue buff. Be happy that somebody warded my blue. So I can steal the enemy blue buff. Camp is up on his top side, so I will probably take everything. Depends on if Rengar comes to his top side or not. But we will see. I don't think he will show up top side very soon. I'm just gonna start over here. We can go for a repeat gank on Garen. But first of all, I'm gonna take his Grump. To not fall too far behind, you know? Okay, Fiora's trading again. Need to finish the Grump ASAP. Oh, okay, Rengar's here. Okay, still got it. Okay, so I knew Garen had no flash, so I just went for a little repeat gank. Now I'm going to base. I think she can push it out, Garen has no TP. So pretty easy stuff over here. I'm just gonna go to the Raptors now. Oh wait, I'm gonna go for my golems. So I have like one camp more than the Ringo, that's the Grump. So he took my whole bot side, I guess. Because he's like 20 CS and I have 24, you know? You can count the camps, but I will teach you that in next movie, the next videos maybe. We will see. What do you guys want to know? Just tell me in the comments down below what stuff you want to see, what champions you want to see. I can't play everything, you know, but I still... I'm going to try to make at least a good gameplay video for some champions. And when the response will be pretty good, I will do like maybe a daily series out of this. I don't know, you will see. Okay, I see my blue is gone. Grump's still here. He's still the last Grump. So my bot lane did a kill. Top lane should be pretty much over, but she can still fuck it up. It's still Garen, you know. Take the Grump fast. To help him push the lane out. Yeah, should be. Yeah, okay. So I didn't want to cast skill, you know, but the Vlad would have flashed or ran away. So I just took it. Oh, look at this, yeah. I'm kind of sad I didn't check this much earlier, but maybe I can still rotate on the Veigar. Okay. Oh my god, I fucked up my... Yeah. I fucked up my Q. Wasn't the best stuff, but... Okay. Still okay, I guess. Veigar blew his flash. I'm gonna put some pressure now to Vladimir. But I can't do much here over here. A little bit of damage. I know he has no ult, so still can go for my red buff and take any damage because I will heal a lot. Just consume potions. With the fighting, don't take any damage. I'm even sustaining more than I take, you know. So I most of the time smite the big golem, the 70 gold golem, because it takes Graves a lot of time to kill it, and it does the most damage from every camp. It even does more damage than the red buff or even the blue buff. So you have to decide on your own what camp you're smiting, but I always go for the big crack. So I'm gonna wait for the okay, it's spawned now. I have to go base, I guess. An enemy has been slain. Watch for top lane gank. He should have flash again. Not much I can do over here. Bot lane is kind of stomping. Just gonna. Okay, he did his blue. But warded over the. Okay, maybe Fiora will be there. Okay. Garen used his ignite. Dashed again, okay. Maybe we can get a plate. So whenever you have control over a lane in the early game, always try to take the free gold from the plates over here. Okay, he survived pretty nice stuff from the Fiora. Okay, Rengo good. Okay. Didn't know what... Maybe I lagged or... some kind of stuff. I don't know. I don't know what I've been doing there. Maybe I was CC'd or stuff? I don't know. Anyway. Game goes pretty good. It's 9-1, you know? So, I'm gonna finish my item over here. I will go for a BF sword now for the Stormraiser. Second item, pink ward, and now I'm going to upgrade my warding totem into an oracle lens to deny vision from the enemies and to snowball even further, you know? So always when you have a lead on the enemies, get an oracle lens as soon as possible. And always use it on cooldown when you are in enemy territory or ganking a lane, so it even disables wards, you know. There we go over here now. Try to support the. Okay, he has ult, so I don't know if this guy has. I don't know. Should have ulted him. Oh, okay. I just thought he would press R, but I don't know. Okay, Fiora is getting killed by the Ringer, I guess. Maybe I can rotate on the bot lane. Trying to. Yeah, okay. Does engage by the Rakan. Okay. Easy kill. Yeah. They overstayed. So it's pretty see. The Rakan already got his Oracle Lens. It's pretty helpful against Shrooms from Demo 2. So I will give them the Drake, the first tower, because they already did it. I will start the Drake to get even more snowball going. Okay, go to my Grump now. I need like 350 more, like 250 now. So I will clear my top side and then I will recall to finish my second item. Whenever you play Graves, there can be a big trap. So you never will go boom, or you never will go low HP in the jungle. Because Graves is so strong in clearing and sustaining in the jungle. So always spend your gold whenever you can do a little buy. Don't run around like me with 1600 gold, 2k gold, whatever. Always go and spend your gold, please. This is just a little advice for you. Because a lot of Graves players are doing this mistake. We'll take the blue now over here. After that I will sweep the jungle. Yeah, we'll give it over to the Malzahar. He can use it better, I guess. His ult is like, I don't know, I just call it the outplay button. You know? Like Syndra ult or Alts ult. All the stuff that is like point and click. Okay, I guess I'm dead, but I don't know. Okay, I flashed. I don't know. Will he? Okay. guess Rengar is the only one in the enemy team who's playing well, at least, you know. But I could have killed him, I got like 2.3k gold in my pocket. And I would have get my two item power spike and my ninja tabis, you wouldn't have any chance to kill me. But that's the point I mean. Whenever you are the person that has to carry the game. And most of the time you are the person that has to carry the game. Never run around with like 2k gold before fights. I never force stuff. I mean, there's always the point when the game is over where you can fool around a bit. But in solo queue, when you want to climb, the ladder, should avoid doing this stuff. I already saw a lot of games that were won like this. Go to the enemy, you know? So, whenever you play ranked, always go for patience and lower your mistake rate. Okay, pushing now for the tier 2. Rengar is the only one getting kills, doing kills, whatever. Eren is only level 9, like level 12. Okay. Holy shit, he's fast. Okay, he missed his bola. Still going to chase me? Oh yeah. Yeah. They really want blood. Okay, I will recall. Sell my little refillable potion. Get my phage. Pretty nice recall. Yara went like Rengar 7-1, you know? I keep on feeding him, but he's like more than half of the kills of his team. I don't know. I don't think he can carry, but we will see. Never say never. At least he's trying, you know.
Let's set the score.
Okay, I'm gonna clear. He's doing the Rift Herald. I'm gonna. During the mid lane. Holy shit. He's at it on him. I'm gonna take my red buff. Look for some picks now. So now we all just have to pick like one or two enemies and we'll get like three turrets. Maybe we could even go for Baron. So I'm gonna scan the whole part over here. I'm gonna use this plant. Think about the Baron. Okay. Reach this guy. I would like to go for Baron, but Fiora is like top lane. But we still have the. Okay. S. Rango isn't playing that bad. He dodged my ult, he dodged my Q. Isn't falling for stupid stuff, this guy. He's 8-2, but most of the kills are just ultimate shutdowns, you know? Just kill people with like 10% overstaying, getting greedy. Okay, we put an inhib. Maybe I can. Okay. Never mind. Can't help somebody getting ulted by Garen, you know? There is no help. Could get my cleaver now, but I'm gonna ping that I have no smite, but I don't think it will matter. Rango was dead, shouldn't have ult now, so okay, that's kinda bad for me. Double kill. Triple, okay. Even smite the break. I have 3k gold now, so I should spend it. Just buying a cleaver, getting zeal, and watching for the turrets. So, when you have a big lead, the best thing is to get the outer three turrets, this, and then take the Rift Herald to snowball your lead even further to get like the tier 2 turrets. Get like every turret over here, mid, top and bot, and then try to get some picks. Like on the cage. Tristana got one shot by Rango. Not much I can do over there. We have like all the three inhibitors, so this game is pretty much over. Demo Shroom still going off, doing a lot of damage, but it doesn't matter. Yeah. And finished the game. Yeah, guys, so that's the game. I hope you will leave a like or a comment or maybe even a sub, I don't know, depends on you. You also can follow me on all social media, Twitter, links below the video. See you next time.